Here's my 10 construction tips.
Number 1. Vehicle assembly or the spaceship hangar. The key difference in construction is symmetry mode. In the VAB, you get many copies, and you also build up and down. Notice how these wheels are opposites. In the spaceship hangar, symmetry is parallel. Your parts are also snapped in horizontally, so you can build along the hangar floor. Symmetry mode is like a mirror. Note how these wheels face the same direction. Number 2. Master parts. Let's refer to the parts you start with as a master part. As you attach more and more parts, the place where you started is kind of like the beginning of a branch on a tree. It's often good practice to build a single branch, complete it with all of the parts, and then reattach it in symmetry mode. Master parts also work as the attachment point for your subassemblies. Subassemblies are basically a clipboard for a collection of parts.
The master part is also used to move your vehicle.
Number 3. Mass, lift, thrust. Using the buttons in the lower left, you can see your relationship of your center of mass to your center of lift or thrust. Notice how it's totally askew here.
Often building things with symmetry is ideal.
You can use these readouts to predict what your craft will do in flight. The center of lift, displayed in blue, is always best kept near the center of mass. Keep in mind that as you fly, your center of mass is going to change as you burn fuel. Keep an eye on your center of lift as you move your flight surfaces. Number 4. Right-click toggles. Right-clicking parts in the builder can reveal options, handy for construction, but also for flight. For example, adjusting an engine's thrust can show us how the center of thrust and mass will be related while using different engines. A handy tool for checking how your center of mass is going to change as you burn fuel, or storing less oxidizer for air-breathing engines. Adjusting flight surfaces can also improve your aircraft's controllability. I've found disabling yaw on horizontal surfaces and disabling pitch on vertical ones can sometimes help aircraft fly a great deal better. Adjusting an engine's thrust can be handy for radical designs to line up your center of thrust and center of mass. Number 5. Action groups. Using this tools button at the top, you can set the number keys to do any number of functions on various parts. Turning off or toggling engines, toggling intakes, activating parachutes, docking ports and decouplers. Creating action groups improves usability and saves lives. Number 6. Staying aligned. If you should end up in a situation where you can't use symmetry mode, but you want things to stay more or less lined up together, a handy trick can be using the textures on a part. Looking at a part's texture relative to your parts can help you know if you're lined up. Checking your creation against the floor can help you know if things like boosters are lined up. Sometimes it's handy to temporarily attach a part just to use as a level. This can help to keep additional parts lined up on complicated projects. Number 7. Rotation. While you have a part selected, using the same buttons you use to control your spacecraft's rotation during flight, Q, W, E, A, S, and D, you can change a part's rotation in the builder. To rotate a part in small increments, hold Shift. Sometimes it helps to keep other things aligned by counting how many times you've rotated a part. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Alt is another important button for copying parts. And X toggles how many copies you get in symmetry mode. Sometimes it's also better to turn off angle snap. Number 8. Test things. It's often a good idea to start with a test rig. Build your idea small with as few parts as possible. Eliminate variables, and weed out your issues. This can save you a lot of time when you take your idea to scale. Be sure and test your hatches before you get too involved in a project. Nothing is more frustrating than cannot exit. It's nice to know ahead of time if your IVAs work, your landing gear works, your parachutes work, your escape systems work, and more importantly, what didn't work. Number 9. Mechjeb. Mechjeb is an autopilot mod, but it's also really useful for stats in the builder. Comparing your Delta V numbers to ones found online can give you some insight as to how far your spaceship will go. Eliminating human error while you test your rockets can save you a great deal of time. Number 10. Persistence attaching. Just because the game thinks a part won't go there, doesn't mean it won't go there. Sometimes just attaching things individually, trying to reattach, or even changing your camera angle will let parts that are in the red turn green. Remember to experiment rotating parts for some interesting designs.
I hope at least a couple of these tips help somebody out. Thanks so much for watching.